I've made a copy of ODB9, Protect the Field, Add Buttons, and renamed this to ODB10, Filter, Background. On the database window, we've got form selected, and I'm going to open the employees form by double-clicking on it. In the last video, we sorted our data by last name and then by first name, and we used the sort icon down here on our navigation toolbar. When we did this, we didn't talk about the buttons right next to it. We've got auto filter, apply filter, form-based filters, and remove filter. We'll notice that the remove filter is active. I'm going to click on this and remove the filter. We see that it goes back to sorting by employee ID, and the filter is inactive. If I sort this again by last name, ascending, we see the filter becomes active. Let's remove this and look at the filters a little more. This button right here that says form-based filters, if I click that, it brings up our filter navigator window. We'll also notice that all our text boxes are empty. They're empty because it will allow us to apply a filter. Let's filter by department. We'll make this the IT department, so I'm clicking IT in here. And if I hit enter or tab, we see department show up in our filter navigator. Let's also add in a gender. We want to see all the females that work in the IT department. So I'll type in female. So it will sort on department and female. To apply the sort, we need to come down here and click on the apply form-based filter. And we see Helen Martinez in the IT department. We can go to the next record. Karen Robinson, Sandra Lewis, Nancy Clark, and that's it. We have four of them. Now let's go in and edit that filter. I'm going to come down to our form-based filters and open back up our filter navigator. If I want to change this to say department IT or gender female, I'll click on gender and drag it over into the next filter. Now we have filter for department IT or gender equals female. Let's apply this filter. And we need to click through these one at a time to see the results. It's a little more difficult. To see how this filter works, we may want to create another form. I'm going to close this, go into our form wizard, we only have our table, I'm going to select everything, clicking next, we're going to skip the subform, arrange the controls, spreadsheet view, this is what we want. We're going to leave the defaults for the data entry. We're going to change this to the blue ice, since that's what we picked for our other form. And our name, instead of employees 2, we're going to make this employees spreadsheet view. And click on finish. Okay, we have all our data here. It's not filtered at all because the filter did not carry over to the new form. So we'll create a new one for this form. And we'll start with gender equals female, just like we did before. And let's also add in the department IT. Apply the form. And now we see our four employees that are female in the IT department. Opening back up the filter. Now if we take department and move it into the other filter, we can have it say filter for gender equals female or department equals IT. Let's apply this filter. And we see a couple of male in there. And going to the right, we see that they're also in the IT department. Let's remove this filter. And I'm going to just take another minute here to talk about the auto filter. The auto filter will filter on the cell we're on. if we select employee ID equal to 2 and hit auto filter, it brings up one record because there's only one that has employee ID equal to 2. Let's clear this filter. Let's say that we click on mail and then click on the auto filter. This will select only males. And if we further select IT department and then apply the auto filter again, we get only the males in the IT department. I'm going to clear this filter. And I'll also mention the quick sort here. If we sort by last name, works the same way. Clicking on last name and then clicking sort ascending, sorts them by last name ascending. There's a lot more we can do with this sorting and filtering, but it will all make more sense after we've learned about queries and how they work, because our sort and our filter are basically just queries. Let's close this form and go back to our employees form. We want to look at changing the background color. To do that, we come into Format. And the first thing we see is we can't change this in Open View. We need to close out of Open View and go into Edit View. Right click, Edit. To change the background color, we would come up to Format, Page, and in the Background tab, we have all our colors. We can also make it a graphic. We're going to go back into Color and change this to yellow. It's a little bright. Let's go into No Fill. With No Fill, you can see little dotted lines in the background. These grid lines are to help us line up our objects when we're setting up our forms in edit mode. If we change this to black, they show up a little better. Now, to go back to that original ice blue color, it's going to be a little difficult because the LibreOffice-based default colors are not in the color palette. I had to add that in. The ice blue color numbers are 153, 204, 204. I had to look those up using a color picker, then add that into my color palette. We can get back to that color. If we want to place in a background graphic, we can select it and just drag and drop, or we can right click and cut and paste. That's all pretty standard stuff. It may show up in front, so we might have to right click on it, arrange, and send to back. But once it's on there, we can resize it as we like. We'll notice that the graphics and the frame toolbars are available. Those were all covered in the writer series. If you want your image to cover the entire background, you may want to use the format page, but you don't have to. We've got one more way to change the background or add a picture, and that's with the gallery. Clicking my gallery icon opens up the gallery, and from here, we've got a selection of pictures. We can grab one and place it on the page, or we can right-click, Insert as a background. We're going to add this to the whole page, and it changes the background for the whole page. We've got rocks and bricks. We'll do rocks. Insert, background, page. A little bit busy. Maybe we need something with a little less texture. How about this one? Light sand. Insert, background, page. That looks good, but let's take off the orange. We'll close the gallery. Now let's save the form. Closing that and saving the database. Yeah.